So how do we screen for patients with Down syndrome? It is common, especially in mothers of advanced age, to do standardized routine screening for Down syndrome. Generally, we will try to screen in the first trimester. Or in the second trimester, we can do the triple or quadruple screen. That's very important. Also, we can do a level 2 fetal ultrasound. Screening identifies infants who are at risk for potential Down syndrome. It is not diagnostic, and there is absolutely a false positive rate. If they don't want to ever do invasive testing, there is probably no role for screening. But if they do want to do invasive testing, then the screen is a reasonable thing to do, because the next step would be to invasively test and see if that infant truly has Down syndrome. The way we would do definitive testing in utero is generally through chorionic villus sampling. This happens around 10 to 12 weeks of gestation, or we can do amniocentesis around 16 to 20 weeks of gestation. The idea is we're going and getting actual cells from the actual baby and then doing a karyotype to figuring out what their genetic potential is. So we're going to send that for karyotype. Here's a karyotype. This is how we would confirm a diagnosis or do an in utero diagnosis. It confirms essentially whether the patient has either a translocation or has a de novo 3 copies in the cell. So patients with Down syndrome have a longer and longer life expectancy now in the United States. As recently as 1983, the average life expectancy was 25, and then in 2002, it was 49. A lot of this came from better standard therapies for a lot of the complications of these children. We have to attend to their hearing loss and give them hearing implants or hearing aids if they're having a problem with hearing. Of course, we're going to treat their hypothyroidism aggressively. One final complication in adulthood I'd like to mention is early onset Alzheimer's disease. This is very prevalent and happens in about 10% of 50-year-olds with trisomy 21 and even 75% of 60-year-olds with trisomy 21. It happens because the amyloid precursor protein gene, or APP, is actually on the 21st chromosome. So they have a genetic predisposition to early onset Alzheimer's. Before I close, I want to say something in general about patients with Alzheimer's. These children tend to be extremely happy, extremely loving, and wonderful to parent. They live amazing and positive lives, and they have great attitudes. It's really interesting that these children live such happy lives. One wonders if, in many ways, it might be a blessing for a child to have trisomy 21. It's something we should support these families. We should give them all the medical support they need and the social support they need, but recognize that these children are valuable contributors to society. They're wonderful kids. Thanks for your time.